I don't want to kill any plants in my garden unless I have to. And most of the time, I don't have to. In fact, it's pretty easy to keep plants alive if you understand when to put the seeds in the ground and when to put plants outside. And that's what I'm talking about today, is understanding cool season plants and warm season plants and how best to grow them in your garden. Hi, I'm Gardener Scott, and I'm in my garden today because it's time for me to start thinking about putting some seeds in the ground. We're only a week into spring, and the ground is still pretty cool and the nights are still pretty cold, but I can actually start growing some cool season plants. And the name implies that they like cool weather. In fact, most of them can actually handle cold weather. So what kind of plants am I talking about? Well, cool season plants are plants like asparagus and beets and broccoli and Brussels sprouts and cabbage. It's plants like kale and lettuce and spinach and peas and chard. It's additional root plants like carrots and turnips and parsnips and radishes. All of those are cool season plants. And I'll put a good list in the description so that you have a good understanding of what plants you might be growing that are cool season plants. An important thing to realize about the cool season plants is that most of the time they don't like hot weather. And so that's why we grow them in early spring typically, is because when it gets really hot in the summer, that's when they'll start sending up their flower stalks and start setting seeds. And most of these cool season plants just don't taste very good once that process begins. That's called bolting. And when a spinach plant sends up its stalk loaded with flowers and then seeds, it's really not very good to eat after that point. So we're growing cool season plants in cool conditions, like early spring. You can also grow cool season plants at the end of your growing season, in the fall. And I think that's one of the best benefits in growing these plants. You grow them in the spring, you grow the warm season plants in the summer, and then you grow cool season plants again in the fall. So now let's talk about those warm season plants that fit there in the middle during a typical growing season. Those are the plants that all of us envision when we think about a summer garden. Those are the beans and the cucumbers. They're the peppers and the squashes, to include pumpkins and zucchini. They're the tomatoes. They're eggplants. It's all of those plants that are just so robust during the heat of summer. And that's why we call them warm season plants, because they require warm conditions to grow. In fact, all of those plants, if they're exposed to freezing conditions at all, they'll die. Freezing weather will kill warm season plants. So that's why we grow them in between the cool shoulder seasons, because that's the only time of the year that they'll survive. So what does that mean for me today, the first week of spring in my garden? Well, I have to look at the season. Is it a cool season or is it a warm season right now? And right now the temperatures are in the 50s, and tonight they're going to drop below freezing. What does that mean? Well, based on what I just said, I cannot be growing warm season plants today because they would die. But those conditions are suitable for growing cool season plants. In fact, I can put some of those seeds in the ground right now of the cool season plants, and I can expect germination and growth before summer even arrives. And that's an important difference between the cool season and the warm season plants, generally speaking. Cool season plants, we can start from seed. Warm season plants, generally, we transplant into the garden as a seedling or a plant that's already growing. Because warm season plants typically take a long time to grow and fruit, and so it's much easier for us to put a plant in the ground after the conditions are just right and warm enough for them to continue. Wouldn't it be great if there was a date that we could use to determine when we can start the cool season seeds or put the warm season plants in the ground? Well, believe it or not, there is such a date, and it's called your last frost date. I actually have a video that helps explain what that means. You should know your last frost date because you definitely do not want to be putting warm season plants in the ground before your last frost date. And you probably actually want to wait a week or two after your last frost date before you start putting those warm season plants in the ground. But as far as the cool season plants, well, we can put seeds in the ground in the spring in most cases as soon as the soil can be worked. So my soil is actually relatively moist. It's not frozen anymore. And so I can put my cool season seeds in the ground right now. It will influence the germination, the soil temperature and the air temperature as far as how soon before the last frost date I choose. But believe it or not, some of the seeds like cabbage and spinach, they can actually germinate well when the soil temperature is in the 40 degree range, which is pretty cold. Every day that this soil warms up underneath the sun, I can expect my germination to happen much, much faster. So I will typically wait until about 4 to 6 weeks before my last frost date for many of my cool season seeds. And for me, that date is fast approaching. In fact, right now I'm about 5 weeks away from my last frost date, which is why I'm out in the garden today. For the discussion so far, I've been referring to an open garden space like this, but you can actually fool the seeds and the plants a little bit if you work with a season extending system. And that's a system of using hoops covered in plastic or even a full greenhouse. It's systems like wall of waters that you might put around some of those warm season plants. And so even though I wouldn't normally put a tomato in the garden until about 2 weeks after my last frost date, if I surround it with a system like wall of water, I can actually put it in my garden 2 weeks before the last frost date because that wall of water keeps the plant and the soil warm, fooling it into thinking that it's growing during a warm season. As far as the cool season plants are concerned, it's not as easy to fool them. But if you start a little later than you normally would like, you can use things like shade cloth to cover the cool season plants when the weather really starts getting hot. And as long as those plants stay relatively cool in a shady spot, you can grow them into the summer pretty far. Another way is to actually look for plants, either warm season or cool season, that have been bred to handle some of those extreme weather conditions. So you might find a spinach, for instance, that is sold as a slow bolt spinach. And what that means is it can handle warm conditions before it sends up its flower stalk. And you might actually find some tomatoes, like a glacier tomato, that can handle some cooler conditions. So at the end of the season, when maybe it's starting to cool off and most other tomato plants would begin to suffer, a tomato or a pepper or any warm season plant that's been bred to handle some of those cool conditions will probably do just fine. When we grow plants at the appropriate time during the season, not only do we avoid killing them, but we get the best in the way of flavor and growth. Who doesn't like that squash or pepper or eggplant during the height of summer when its flavor is right at its peak? The same holds true for the cool season plants. While I like growing cool season plants in the spring, I find that the best flavor actually happens with the fall crops. So some of those plants, like zucchini, for instance, that I might be pulling out of my garden at the end of August for me, the end of the summer, that's when I'm putting in some of the cool season seeds. And they're actually growing well through the fall, and it's at the end of fall that their flavor really reaches the peak. Because when a plant like a beet or a carrot is exposed to some of those light frost conditions, all the sugars and the intensity of flavor within those root vegetables just can't be beat. This weather feels pretty good to me right now, but I really need to think about it from the plant's perspective. Because one day of good weather may not be enough for a plant to germinate and begin growing. So what I use is the magic number 50. For me, when the nighttime temperatures are above 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 10 degrees Celsius, then I can put my warm season plants in the garden. Because once nighttime temperatures stay above 50 degrees on a regular basis, I don't have to worry about those frost conditions killing any of my plants. And on the other side, once the daytime temperatures are staying regularly above 50 degrees, then I can be growing those cool season plants, and they'll be doing just fine. Remember, they can handle some cold conditions. So even though the nights might drop down to or slightly below freezing, those cool season plants will still survive once we have days like this that are staying regularly above 50. If you have any comments or questions about how these cool season plants and warm season plants might work in your garden, please let me know below. If you want to see more of these informational gardening videos, well, then you can subscribe to the Gardener Scott channel if you haven't already done so. If you like this video, you can give me a thumbs up and share it. I'm Gardener Scott. Enjoy gardening.